Hi, my name is John and I am going to do a cleaning vinyl records tutorial. The other day I did a unboxing of my Audio-Technica LP120 and I played a record which I had already cleaned, and it was the first record I ever played and I posted it. So what I want to do is I came up with an idea of how to kind of hold the records as I'm cleaning them. There are different methods out there, obviously. I would have mentioned, I think in my first video, people using wood glue and other things like that. But if you watched the first video and you heard the track I played after my cleaning, you would have noticed that it was pop and crackle free. So I'm going to show you what I do. So let's go through the items that I use. Okay, so this is what I am using, and I'll tell you everything I bought. This is a plastic tray and it is about 35 centimeters, about 13 inches, something like that. So it is bigger than a record, and I picked that up for about $2-3, and it's plastic. It's strong plastic, it's not flimsy, and that's one of the items. If you can find something like that, plastic is easier to work with than metal, and is also lighter as well. I bought this. Now, this is probably the most expensive thing. It's only $10, but it's a thin piece of non-slip rubber with a sticky backing, which I haven't cut yet, and I just bought a square of that. That was $10. Again, inexpensive, but basically I'm going to use that, cut that in a circle that fits snugly into there, and that will actually hold the records from slipping around, as well as the lip in here. Now to hold the tray, now I can hold it by hand, but I bought this as well, which was only a couple of bucks, and it's basically a kitchen handle that goes like this. Now the reason I bought this particular one is because you can kind of get your hand underneath it and kind of hold the tray. So if you imagine this underneath a tray, you can kind of navigate it quite well, kind of tilt the record around and things like that. Now what do I use? Is dishwasher liquid, just a few drops of that and some water, and one of these, which I mentioned were featured in my first video, a different version of it, but this is a square one. Now this, if you have a look, imagine the record in there, it actually covers the circumference of the record quite well. So this square one here, they cost about $8 or $9 for the handle and a couple of these. Now they're very microfiberish pointy hairs. I don't know if you can actually see them in the video, but they're basically really fine hairs, and they get into the grooves quite well with a soapy water, and you basically clean them, which we're going to be doing later. And you get a spare one in there, and you can, you know, interchange them, but really they're going to last. And the last thing, bag of microfiber cloths, which I got for about $4. Okay, I'm back and I've made the cleaning device, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean a record, and then we're going to play it and we're going to see how it sounds. Okay, so this is obviously the Rocky soundtrack. I never even knew I had this. I got actually the Rocky 2 soundtrack as well, and I can't remember last time I played any of these records. This has been 15 years. The other day I played the Idol Maker and some swing music as well in the last couple of days, and they've been sounding awesome. I've also got this album, it's really good. It's the Billy Joel's The Stranger. Again, I'm gonna clean that and have it in my rack ready to play. Some other albums I got, I bought some big swing albums, I remember, about 15 years ago, just different types of albums here. It's really good to listen to, like Glenn Miller and other big band kind of music. It's really nice to listen to. So these albums, I can't remember what I paid for them. I think I got them like for $5 each at the time, but now records are really coming back in. So what we're going to do is we're going to clean the Rocky soundtrack, and I'm going to play it, and we're going to see how we go. Okay, so I'm going to get this out. Got a plastic cover on it that's actually folded in and stuck in. It's kind of odd. I may just leave that for now, because I did buy a whole bunch of new covers, and I'm going to change them as I go. Now, the problem with this also is, see, we've got an inner sleeve that's actually paper. Now, I do want to buy some inner sleeves because it's important to have the right ones. The paper ones apparently do create dust. Now, this particular album, I can see there's a whole bunch of dust, and back then, I wasn't even cleaning these albums right, so all of them were going to get a once over. So let's go to the sink and see the setup and get it done. Okay, so I hope this comes out well. So earlier I showed you the things that I used to make this. Now, so we've got a tray. This was a non-slip padding that had a sticky back, which I cut out with scissors and took my time. And basically I drew a record, and then it was a little bit bigger than the record. It's about 31 centimeters. And underneath, this handle is really good. It actually sits actually above as well, which is really good, just the way it was designed. And all this costs under $20. So what I do is I hold it like this now, and I can hold the record, and it won't slip down here, and I can actually clean it. In here, I've got soapy water, a little bit of dishwashing liquid, some warm water to break down the liquid. And it's basically the little brush here, which is used for painting along the edges. So we're going to clean the Rocky soundtrack, and we're going to use a little bit of water. Now, not too hot and not too cold either. You just want this kind of warm water. So I'm going to get the record. And basically, as you can see, the record just sits in here. And try not to over wet the label. You just basically get this, and you can go around, and it kind of sits in the groove. I'm just make sure that you guys can see this. It's as simple as that, and the record doesn't even slide because of the non-slip. Just go around a couple of times, and then just a bit of water, and you can just pick up the album, or you can just flip it over, whatever's easier. You can do the same on the other side. Like the water's a little bit strong there, so again, it's a little bit of soap. Nothing more than this. We're obviously going to test this as well, because I'm going to put it on in a minute. And just again, now you can just rinse it. Tray makes it very easy to hold with the handle in the back. Do this on the other side as well. Just give it a good rinse. Okay, and just holding in the label here in the middle. And the next step is straight onto the microfiber cloth over here. And I've got a second microfiber cloth. And basically, hopefully you can see that. I think it's in frame, but now. These cloths are brand new, and it's probably just as important to keep your microfiber cloths or your cleaning equipment in a box dust free. Because if these aren't clean, then what's the point of doing this? This record looks really, really good. It doesn't need anything else. As far as any little speckles of dust go, they will come off with a carbon fiber brush, and that's it. That's all you need to do. No wood glue, okay? No strong solutions, no big mechanics, all these contraptions with water pressure. You don't need any more of this. So I'm gonna play this record now, and we're gonna find out. Okay, so the record is on there, and I'm just turning the turntable on. It's set at 33, and I'm going to grab this. This is what came in the mail finally, and basically I just go ahead and hit start, and I'm just going to rest this on, just let it go around once or twice, and then just take it off, and that's it. You don't need to do anything else. Now I'm just going to line this over. Just turn my light on here. This thing looks pretty good. Turn my amplifier on. Okay, everything's on. And I'll just turn it up a little bit as well. I think that should be loud enough. And let's drop this needle. Let's see what we've got. Okay, so that was it, and you saw for yourself. I had cleaned that record for 15-20 years. I didn't remember the last time I even played it. Very simple process, along with the carbon fiber brush, just give it a last sweep for little specks of dust, which you can't help because there's always going to be dust in the air, which is floating dead skin and all the rest. Static causes them to cling to the album from the moment you take it out of the sleeve. But you do not need to keep washing and putting treatments on your albums. That's all you need to do, what I just did then. And you can make that for under $20. And yeah, just do what I did, and hopefully you won't have any trouble playing your records, and they will be as clear as that one. Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.